For Bashar Assad, it was the first meeting with President Medvedev. More than getting acquainted, he wanted to show his support.
We would like to express our support to Russia's stance in the recent conflict and the situation in Abkhazia and South Ossetia. We understand what is behind Russia's position, and we understand Russia's military reaction to the developments. We believe this is a response to Georgia's provocation. We support Moscow in this and are against any attempts to blacken Russia.
Ahead of the visit, there were reports Russia will deploy its missile systems in Syria, in particular the missile complex Iskander that Syria has been asking for a long time.
We are ready to consider the offer of the Syrian side regarding the purchase of new weaponry. Our position is clear. We are ready to deliver weapons to Syria that are used for defense only and that are not violating the strategic balance in the region.
Many expected tit-for-tat response after the U.S. sealed a deal to deploy interceptors in Poland as a part of their missile defense system. Following NATO's criticism over Russia's actions in South Ossetia and threats to shut down the NATO-Russia Council, there came the news Russia might suspend its cooperation with NATO.
Russia needs mutual cooperation no less than NATO does. Moreover, NATO is far more dependent on Russia's support in its operation in Afghanistan, which is where the fate of the North Atlantic Alliance is being actually decided. We are not going to slam the door on NATO. NATO could slam this door, though. Everything depends on NATO's priorities. If the priorities are absolutely supportive of Saakashvili's bankrupt regime to the detriment of partnership with Russia, then it's not our fault.
Meanwhile, the withdrawal of the Russian troops from the conflict zone has already started.
Tomorrow, our peacekeepers will set up 8 posts on the external side of the security zone according to their plan. A peacekeeping contingent will be deployed at each of these checkpoints with an aim of bringing the number of peacekeepers to no more than 500. All other Russian army units that were sent to the region to reinforce the Russian peacekeepers will be withdrawn to South Ossetia or Russia.
Russia is fully committed to the 6 principles of ceasefire, but according to Lavrov, some of the country's partners are not willing to notice that and use diplomatic tricks.
People have been working with this document quite creatively and liberally. We are categorically against it. Just think about it. The initial paper approved by Medvedev and Sarkozy said that Georgian troops must be withdrawn to their permanent bases. But in the UN resolution, they've tried to replace the word permanent with the expression their usual basis. But the word usual is not a legal term and can mean positions Georgia took prior to its assault on South Ossetia.
As the sites of fighting over the legal terms, South Ossetia, together with another Georgian breakaway region of Abkhazia, once again requested for Russia to recognize their independence.
We fully understand the feelings of the South Ossetians and the Abkhazians. These nations have been under chauvinistic pressure from Georgia over the past 15 years. We've been striving to fulfill our function as mediators and peacekeepers very patiently and consistently for all these years. If someone actually questioned Georgian territorial integrity and struck the hardest blow on it by doing so, it was the present leader of the country, Mikhail Saakashvili.
Question is, how far this understanding might spread? Already on Monday, the Russian parliament will consider a resolution on the crisis in South Ossetia and Abkhazia, and many expect them to speak in unison in favor of their independence. Alexander Koshonitska, RT.